Today we are going to use masking tools in Lightroom app to turn this image to a completely different look. I'm going to start with some basic tuning in the light menu. Starting by decreasing the highlights to get some details from the brighter parts, increasing the shadows for details in the darker areas, tuning the whites and blacks to give some punch to the brightest and darkest parts of the image, also increasing the contrast a bit. Now for the major part of this edit, using the new masking tools. In the masking menu, after clicking the plus button, these are the new options you get. I'm going to ignore the first two options as they are still in preview stage. Below, in addition to the first three, we have got new color range and luminance range options. We'll be using all these masking tools now to make selective edits to the image. We'll start with the luminance range. This masking tool can be used to select areas having similar brightness or darkness. I'll be selecting the sky here using this tool. So placing the eyedropper over the sky to select brightest parts of the image. Here on the right, fine-tuning the selection, trying to limit the selection to the bright parts of the sky. As you can see, parts on the vintage car too has similar brightness. We'll remove the mask on the car by tapping on this plus or minus symbol button and selecting subtract from mask. Choosing the brush option here and brushing on the car and the foreground to make sure the selection is only on the parts of the sky. Now going to the light menu and reducing the brightness over the sky. Also in the color menu, reducing the temperature to turn the sky to blue. Now to get selection on the reddish part of the car, I will be using the color range masking tool. When the eyedropper is placed on any part, it selects all the parts with similar colors. Placing it on the car, refining the selection by dragging the slider towards left. In the color menu, changing the hues to give the car more of a bluish tint. Fine-tuning the selection a bit. We still have some parts selected on other parts of the image. We'll try removing it by subtracting the selection from the mask and brushing out those parts. Going to light menu, adding some contrast, and also in the effects menu, more texture. One more color range filter on the grass will make the color more orangish. Now I will add a couple of linear gradient masks on the top and bottom to make those parts darker. one radial gradient at the center. Here I will invert the mask and reduce the brightness, which gives a nice vignette effect. One luminance range mask on the roof to make it darker. Now to get the light switched on, I'm going to use the radial gradient masks. Adding one here on the headlight. Increasing the exposure and temperature. Also adding orangish color with more saturation. Duplicating the mask and moving it to the other headlight. One smaller radial gradient mask on the light to make it look more natural. Duplicating and placing it on the other light. One brush mask on the glass here to make it darker. Some color tuning in the HSL sliders to give some grading to the image. More tuning in the details menu. also tuning the curves to get that dark look. The final result here. Hope you found the video useful. Thanks for watching.